saga conmigo, ¿sí?
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Bella.
Today I'm with
Lilith. Again. Well, so I'm from Argentina.
20%.
Okay.
Yeah. Hi guys. I'm Bella. This is
Leylin.
Okay, so I'm from Jamaica and I'm an ¿Qué pasa? I'm a Jamaican living in Argentina, if you don't know, and I'm here to share my experiences with you. And Leylin is an Argentine, and today we'll be making
alfajores de maicena.
Alfajores. So what are alfajores?
Bueno.
So alfajores it's like a little sweet snack.
They come in very different forms or recipes. You can buy them like Milka, I don't know if this brand exists, or Oreo. Or there are different
like
brands
this?
That make...
Not
Milka. there are many different brands that make their version, which is basically a cookie, or two cookies with dulce de leche in the middle.
Mm-hmm. Or caramel, we call them in.
Caramel. It is like condensed milk. You can make it at home with condensed milk and you boil it like for a very, very long time, like in baño maría.
Oh, and that is what gives it the color? Or do you have to add something
to
give it the color?
No, yes, that's what gives it the color. It becomes like a como un caramelo, sí.
Oh.
Yes. My mom used to do it like this when we were in Spain and we didn't have dulce de leche. It wasn't so common. Now there's a lot more of exportation.
Right, because there are more Argentines living in Spain. So,
and the version that we're going to do today is the traditional. I'm not going to make them from scratch. We are not, because I'm not good at it. I have to confess. But in Argentina, in the last year, like lately, we have like a lot of products that help you to make traditional things, but in an easy way.
That's
so
cool.
They sell you the comb. They sell you the book, the cookie, mm-hmm. or biscuits, or I don't know how would you call them. But it is basically made out of. Maicena?
Mm-hmm. Maicena
flax,
no, cornstarch.
Cornstarch, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, they're made out of cornstarch, and then you put like dulce de leche inside. We're going to show you. In this mm-hmm. case, it's dulce de leche repostero, which is thicker because usually the traditional one. It falls from the like it is very it has the texture of honey.
Right.
Kind of.
Well,
yes.
It flows.
It flows. Like, yes.
More
it flows.
Of a liquid texture than.
So it's not so practical when you are like doing things like sweet things. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so we bought this one, repostero, which in English is repostero. How do you say repostero in English?
No sé.
Okay, so
it's like stuff for baking.
Yes,
baking.
Yes, like stuff for baking. That's it. And then you put here this coco rallado,
mm-hmm.
which is
grated coconut.
Yes, grated coconut, and it's going to taste. You're going to see, super buenardo. Va a estar buenardo. Which is another expression, weird expression from Argentina to mm-hmm. mean, which is going to be very good.
Buenardo.
Yes. Muy bueno, muy buenardo. Muy rico, Ricardo. Ricardo is also a name.
¿Pero dónde? Sí, por eso.
Yes, so that's the joke of it. So, as I told you, Argentinians are very creative with that.
Right, very interesting.
Yes, so we're going to start. I'm going to open this package. It comes with quite a few.
We're not going to count them today.
I'm not going to count them. And Bella is going to help me.
Oh yeah, I'm going to help.
Have you ever done it?
No, actually, I didn't know that they actually sold these. Like,
can I tell you a joke?
These
not a joke. Something interesting.
Uh-huh.
I've never done it. Well, I have. Actually, I have because my mom used to do it like actually like homemade.
Right.
My mom is a very good cook, so I used to do the job of taking the cookie, putting the mm-hmm. dulce de leche and then the coconut. So. I have done it.
You've
never
done it before.
Never.
Okay, guys. So now we're at
the Alpha Whore factory and you're gonna look at how Alpha Whores are made. And I'll show you after what an Alpha Whore is.
El alfajor, tal cual lo conocemos hoy, tiene su origen en la cultura árabe. Su antigüedad se remonta a los principios del siglo XVIII y consistía en... no, mejor que se lo cuente mi amigo. Se lo presento. Mi amigo Emir Armadamasa.
Permíteme que te cuente que entre las costumbres de mi pueblo, la que más me gusta es el alajó. El término alajó tiene sus raíces en la palabra árabe al-hasú, que significa rellenos.
Y allí se introduce el dulce de leche o dulce de fruta, de acuerdo con la producción del día. También hay dos cilindros de metal, que están paralelos al cuerpo de la máquina. Estos son los cilindros de las tapas. En el centro se encuentra el pico dosificador, que entrega una dosis de 25 gramos a cada alfajor. Después están los niveladores, que sirven para lograr que cada alfajor tenga la altura indicada y evitar así que estén torcidos. Otro componente importante de este sector es la bañadora. Esta es la segunda máquina en la línea de producción. Consta de una resistencia que calienta el almíbar o chocolate a una temperatura de 70 grados y lo expulsa por medio de una lluvia, que va bañando cada alfajor y luego, por medio de una bomba de aire, quita el excedente de cobertura de calidad del túnel, los recoge una cinta transportadora, que es una máquina de última generación, la más nueva en nuestra línea de producción. Funciona trasladando los alfajores secos hasta la envasadora. En su recorrido existen cuatro sensores que van controlando el peso, la temperatura de cada alfajor y detecta cualquier anomalía que pueda existir. En el caso de que ello ocurra, tiene el poder de frenar todas las máquinas de la línea de producción, gracias a que estos sensores están integrados con un panel de LCD.
Bueno,
ahí
vamos. Ok, agarramos una carita. Vamos a ver cómo sale el primero.
Bueno, te sigo.
Agarró una galleta. Sí, un poquito.
Poquito
dulce.
No, acá come mucho dulce de leche.
Sí, acá se usa como mucho. Hay veces que hay más dulce de leche que galleta. A mí personalmente no me gusta.
Me parece.
Pero lo estoy haciendo así. Pero bueno, ahí está. Voy a apoyar esto acá. Y ahora la parte más divertida. Conste que yo soy muy mala con estas cosas, ¿no? Mira, bueno, me pasé un poquito. Lo voy a sacar así.
Yo puse poco porque soy jamaiquina.
No, en Argentina no se escasea el dulce. Bueno, y esto lo vamos a hacer para ir al parque después, ¿sabes?
Sí.
Porque acá algo que hacemos mucho es ir al parque. ¿Ves? Y esto se pasa así por el coco y queda así.
¡Ah!
Cute. Perdón, ahí.
No, está bien. Y también venden, hay otros tipos de alfajores, ¿no? Uh-huh. Que venden ahí en paquetes como...
Sí, de chocolate.
De chocolate. A veces sí. Tienen dulce de leche adentro, algunos no.
O alfajores de brownie también, que en vez de tener una galletita, tiene brownie. Y son muy ricos.
Ah.
O de nuez, o de algarroba. Como hay opciones saludables también.
La peor de todas, que para mí es un asesinato del alfajor, es la opción del el alfajor con la galleta de arroz. Galletas de arroz, ¿viste?
Eso es una.
Así no.
Y también hay personas que hacen eso en su casa, es algo que se hace mucho en la casa, o la gente prefiere comprarlos, ¿cómo es?
Generalmente se compran. El camarógrafo puede confirmar, se compran, ¿no? Sí, estas son cosas que se compran, igual que las facturas, bueno, otra cosa, something, Spanglish, yeah.
No, hablamos de español.
En español, otra cosa
que sale.
Something that you can, that people usually buy here in Argentina are facturas, which are like pastries.
Right, pastries.
Yes. With dulce de membrillo, which is a fruit, a South American fruit. And dulce de leche also, and crema pastelera, which I don't know how to say in English.
¿Qué es esa crema?
Crema esa de que es como de huevo, que es amarilla, que es dulce.
Ah, yo ni sé qué es.
Es muy rica. It's my favorite, I could say.
Yeah.
Yeah. No chocolate. We don't use, maybe to kind of como bañar algo.
Right. But
you're
not so vegan, right? Like you're most about like the what's it like jam? You're more like jam people.
Yes, jam people.
Like, membrillo.
And there's a lot of, when I came here, it surprised me, it didn't surprise me really, but it was different for me, that people prefer dulce de leche, they prefer dulce de leche to Nutella.
En España se usa mucho.
Mucho Nutella, sí. And it was like, why?
Pero
Nutella.
Ahora, ¿cuál te gusta más?
Nutella.
Todavía.
Yes, no puedo
Argentina
mucho.
Argentina trucha, así
sí,
se dice.
Sí, truchísima. No puedo Nutella puedo comer cucharadas. Dulce de leche es como que me canso.
Sí.
La costumbre de chiquita que comía cucharadas escondidas.
¿Y qué más podemos llevar al parque?
Chipas. Y en el parque venden chipacitos.
¿Qué
que
son chipas?
Son unas bolitas, they're like a bread, a little bread, made out of, también de maicena? Mandioca.
Uh-huh.
How do you say mandioca in English?
¿Cómo se lo voy a decir?
Qué rico, ya quiero comer esto.
Tami is meat.
Bueno, mandioca, subtítulo.
Cassava.
Okay. And this mandioca, and they put cheese on it, and just mandioca and cheese, and I don't know, something else, maybe egg or something. You also get the little package with something that you don't really know what it is, and you just add water and something else, and you can make it at home, not from scratch, but like
you have a pre-mix.
Mix, yes. And this is very used in Argentina.
Yeah, that's something that really got me in Argentina. Like, you can make anything that they sell in supermarkets or in stores. You can make them at home, and they're cheaper,
yes.
And maybe they will, you know, turn out better. So I really like that. You can get your pizza mixture in the supermarket as well.
Yes, it
just about everything.
I felt when I came here and I started having Argentinian girlfriends, they all knew how to cook. I was 21 probably, and I didn't know how to cook. Like, I didn't know how to make a pizza. I didn't know how to just baking and stuff like that.
Right.
Well, and they were like, you don't know, like, and I felt very bad at the beginning. Like, you're not a woman. No, just kidding. Not that, but it is very common here, like cooking instead of or buying and cooking. Instead of buying something like done
already, you know, made.
Yes.
Even though that you guys do that a lot here, though.
Mm-hmm.
You buy a lot of food, you order a lot of food, but you also make a lot of things at home as well. So.
Bueno, entonces, en el parque puedes comprar o comer chipitas, llevar chipitas,
bizcochos,
facturas, bizcochos, which are like
dry cakes.
Yes, dry cakes with made out of butter. Bien fuerte. Explosivo.
Bizcochuelos son los
dragons. Bizcochuelo, ah, ok.
And bizcoches son galletitas.
Los bizcochitos. Uh-huh. Yes, they are very soft, they are tasty, they are made out of butter. And sometimes you have these people in the parks that come with como una asadera, mm-hmm. with a cart, mm-hmm. That has como ay, se me fue las palabras, como coal.
Yeah.
And they sell also
tartas fritas.
Torta fritas. No, torta frita no, torta asada. Which is very common in it has different names all over Argentina. ¿Qué otros nombres hay para la torta frita? No me acuerdo. But it is not healthy at all because it has a lot of fat. Mm-hmm. Like literally they make it out of fat and flour and I don't know what else. And but
salt,
it is
maybe.
Yeah, salt, but it is so tasty and so good.
En Mendoza le dicen sopaipilla.
Sopaipilla,
yeah. A las tortas fritas.
Different names.
Ah, y chipa en... Ah, no, Mendoza no.
Chipacito, Misiones.
Misiones se llama... ¿cómo lo llaman? Sopa paraguaya también. Ah. Misiones, que es algo parecido a chipa.
No. Sopa paraguaya is something paraguayo. But we eat it also in Argentina. That it is not a soup. The literal translation is Paraguayan. Soup,
Paraguayan soup,
mm-hmm. Paraguayan soup. But it is not Paraguayan soup. It is not soup. It is solid, mm-hmm. And it is made out of corn, like something like a corn. It's not a cake because it's mm-hmm. just corn. Maybe eggs and tomato and meat, and it is good. And yes, but it is. Not so common in here in this region, I think. And then, what else can you eat in the park?
Medialunas.
Medialunas, yes.
Which is literally translated to half moon.
Yes, half moon, which is similar to croissant, but it is not a croissant. It's a different recipe. We finished, guys. How many? 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
15.
I should have done like 3 and.
But yeah, I was like, okay, since you want to do
I'm this, not good at math.
We should try them.
Yeah, let's try them. Do you want one? Premio. The prize. They're good. They're good.
I really like dulce de leche, but...
These are really... I think this one's good. Yeah.
Like some mate. Mm-hmm. It's worse.
Oh, and something else because we're getting ready to go to the park mm-hmm. that is very common here. There is two kind of biscuits. There's like a similar recipe that is traditional in Italy that I think is made out of almond dough or something like this or
almendras.
Sí, harina almendras, almond
flour.
Yes, and but this one, well, it's the Argentinian version, and it has dulce de membrillo también.
Mm-hmm. We can open it.
Yeah, sure. And we, of course, are taking mate to the park. There's something like this. Okay, I have to say that I didn't find the traditional brand. This is Marca Carrefour. But it looks pretty good, like... Well, it doesn't. Let me find the... Oh, no. But, well, you can get the idea. They're good, though.
What happened to this membrillo? They're supposed to be, like, pink or red.
The machine was broken. But, well, yeah. They're good.
And this is also good. Another... I see these biscuits a lot.
Yes.
They come to the park or to parties.
Yes, for children as well.
Mm-hmm.
Is this mine?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so here you just like have a lot of different types of biscuits.
Mm. We love biscuits. We love
flour. Argentines eat flour with everything, like everything.
We love sugar.
Flour, right, flour and sugar.
And we go to the park and we just bring something with flour and sugar. It doesn't matter.
Sweet.
Well, yeah, we don't usually take salty things. And at least is chipacito.
All right, or some biscuits, some salt biscuits.
Sí, yeah, mm-hmm. maybe, yeah.
But it's mostly sweet stuff.
And we should prepare some mate, right?
We should. Right? Alright, so guys, when we come back, we'll have mate for you.